Good morning, traders. Matt Weller here, Global Head of Research with Forex.com, coming at you on the 7th of May, 2024. It's a Tuesday, and here are the key things you need to know ahead of today's U.S. session. The big news overnight, as we hinted at in yesterday's video, was the Reserve Bank of Australia meeting. Now, of course, no one expected the RBA to change interest rates, and indeed they did not. But there was a shift from a more dovish bias, a bias where the central bank was hinting that the next move might be a rate cut, to a more neutral bias. The specific phrase that caught a lot of headlines was that the central bank is now not ruling anything in or out when it comes to the next move for interest rates. That said, traders and economists were looking for at least some acknowledgement that we could well see a rate hike this summer. The RBA did not provide that, and as a result, we do see the Aussie weakening a little bit heading into today's U.S. session. In terms of economic data, the only other notable report was the Eurozone retail sales report from back in March. That came in at plus 0.8%. That is stronger than many had expected. That's actually the first increase in that reading since November of last year, and the strongest increase in retail sales since October 2021. So a modest bullish sign for the Eurozone economy. That said, I don't think it's anything that's going to change ECB policy, and I still expect Madame Lagarde and company to cut interest rates this summer. So overall, we're seeing a bit more divergence between the different major central banks, with the RBA moving more toward a potential rate hike, or at least a neutral bias. The Fed certainly in a neutral bias right now, whereas some of the other major central banks, ECB, BOE, are looking at cutting interest rates this summer. Today's chart of the day is the S&P 500. This was in a very strong rally off the November lows, got as high as 5260 before pulling back through late March and into mid-April. Actually, there's a historical tendency for this index to bottom around mid-April, around tax day. We saw that bottom form and prices have been rallying. And actually, in this lower panel, I've marked the three-day rate of change in the S&P 500. That rose to 3% yesterday through yesterday's trade. And that's actually the biggest three-day rally the S&P 500 has seen since November of last year. So we're seeing a lot of bullish signs that are suggesting perhaps we've seen the bottom in this index, at least in the near term. And as long as we remain above that 5,000 level, where the 100-day exponential or 100-day simple moving average and 23.6% Fibonacci retracement converge, then we're going to have a more bullish outlook for the S&P 500. And who knows, sooner rather than later, we could be testing those record highs up at 5260. So that is today's video. Thank you for carving some time out of your day to watch. And if you're catching us on YouTube, please do like this video and subscribe to our channel. It's a great way to show your support and will keep us doing more of these videos moving forward. Thank you.